and some places the quality is quite poor. NSSF survey shows that, you know, some of these are quite good, the impact on assets, and where village communities have benefited, they have more better assets. Also shown in Dries and Kera study, that NREGA had helped usefulness in the villages. Many of the respondents have mentioned that. We also have done recently a study in Maharashtra. About 4,100 NREGA assets we have examined across 100 villages in 20 districts of Maharashtra. Recently the new government said that we are going to have focus on agriculture, NREGA. But our study showed already, 87% of the works are related to the agriculture in Maharashtra. We have not done other states. Many of them said that it has contributed to the rural economy, the assets created. And study also finds that 92% of the selected users report that main occupation is farming from this survey. And also they said that there are some shortcomings, but the resource base and this other things, the productivity of the marginal lands has increased. And also there are, for climate change and other things, you need to have these programs. So because in future, we may have more agriculture on marginal lands. So we need this kind of works much more. And also to cope up with climate change, you need these programs. And also other studies like Indian Institute of Science and other studies also showed that, assets were created. The Tata IMI study also showed that it has helped creating assets. The last one is on impact on migration. Migration also has, had positive, direct and positive impact on reducing distress migration. And some studies have indicated that providing work to closer to home and decent work conditions, migration has reduced. So these are the examples where it has improved the, reduced the migration. The recent proposed changes in NREGA, restricting into 200 districts, although new minister said that it would not be done, many people have criticized that one. Yesterday, Telangana Assembly also said that we should not restrict to few mandals the NREGA. And also they wanted to reduce this labor material ratio. So recently 28 economists have urged Prime Minister, I'm also signed that thing, that we should not restrict to, 200 districts. But Bhagwati and Panagariya have written that NREGA should be phased out in favor of cash transfers. Over time it may be possible, but right now I think still NREGA has a role. On the positive side, recent committee under my chairmanship recommended NREGA wages to minimum wages. Even IPE has given some suggestions on this minimum wages. With consumer price index every year, you can increase the minimum wages with inflation. Lastly, to conclude, the letter to Prime Minister says the following: despite many problems, NREGA has achieved significant results at a relatively modest cost. 0.3% of GDP is not, compared to the social sector development expenditure of 6 to 7%. And majority are women, and close to half are Dalits and Adivasis. And a large body of research shows that NREGA has wide-ranging social benefits. And recent research also shows that corruption levels have increased, reduced. John Rez and others have done recent studies. There is a reduction in the corruption in this scheme. And recently, the EPW editorial says, why this attack on NREGA? Because many of the pink papers are attacking it's a waste of money, 0.3% of GDP, and all. So according to editorial, four positive outcomes are there. One is income security, productive assets, high female participation and empowerment, and modest tightening of rural labor market. But I am not saying everything is rosy about NREGA. There are many problems in the design and implementation. I mean, corruption is there using contractors and overnight and doing many things. Wages are paid late. Gram Sabhas do not always have technical power, not always paid attention to quality assets. NIPFP study suggested some improvement in the fund flows, how fund flow can be reduce the inefficiencies. Evidence on NREGA shows wide variation across states, because some of the administratively better states like Andhra Pradesh and others have done much better compared to Bihar or some other states. That is true of not only NREGA, any scheme you take. So that is not a surprising thing, but it is true. And also, there are many problems with NREGA, but the solution is not throwing away NREGA, but need to improve the performance. So if properly implemented, the potential benefits of what I suggested, 10 benefits listed, are large. But one has to be pragmatic. We cannot do miracles with 0.3% of GDP. And lastly, also, as Professor Radhakrishna mentioned, policymakers must continue to follow the twofold strategy. One is growing fast, because without growth, economic growth, you cannot do anything. But also direct alleviation programs and also social sector expenditures. So MG NREGA is only a part of these efforts in improving the social sector development. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. We had a very interesting talk, very scintillating talk. You brought a number of dimensions. And the recent survey shows that 10% of India's GDP goes in corruption. 10% of India's GDP goes in corruption. Professor Radhakrishna was saying that we spend on R&D 0.5%, US is spending 3%, India's spend on R&D has come down from 3% to 0.5%. China, very recently, in its latest plan, has put R&D spending at 2.8%. They will overtake the US. I think it's a very, very interesting paper. And you are very right, I think, as a person, a commoner, I would say that we should not throw the baby with bathwater. If there are some problems, you can tweak the scheme. But if you don't have an alternative, you just can't. And I think those who talk, Pargadia and Bhagwati, Pargadia was a year junior to me in Rajasthan University, cash transfers. Cash is an inert resource. If cash alone would have enriched the country, there was sufficient cash. We have banks. We have RBI. We can go on printing. But you have to make, I think, the inert resources active. So we have done a very good thing. I'd only say, I think, after your presentation, I think this presentation should have been made in the Indian Parliament. And I am very sure if you had spoken in Indian Parliament, then they would have told, Manrega Rahega. It will not go. Thank you so much. Can I request my colleague, Professor Lakshmi? We have done some work on state enterprise in Karnataka, and therefore we have analyze the role of state enterprise in Karnataka in the removal of poverty. How enterprises have removed poverty, because you have enterprises which work for weaker sections, which work for promotional sections, you have enterprises which work for agriculture. How these enterprises, they have become an instrument of public policy. And through enterprise initiation, how state can achieve the goals. So that's another way, I think, that has not come into prominence, and that has been done by colleagues here. It was a very, very interesting presentation. I think we felt that we have a teacher speaking in the classroom.
I request Professor Lakshmi Kumari to kindly give the token of appreciation to us. So.
And I think, friends, I think with your permission, I'll take Mr. Surendra Mohan to another room. We have an advanced leadership program where we have our public enterprise colleagues who are here for 2 weeks, and 2 weeks they are to spend in different countries, you know, on the globe, understanding the systems of reforms. So Professor Surendra Mohan, Mr. Surendra Mohan will inaugurate that program.